guys, thank you so much for watching today. We're back in Planet Zoo with another one-off habitat build. Of course, because this week, if you're watching this right when it's going live, is launch week for the newest DLC, the North America Animal Pack, released yesterday. And if you missed it as well, there is another speed build that came out yesterday for the California sea lions. Those were the first animal that I built for, and the cougars being the second. Well, rather, I should actually say those are the first couple videos that have come out, not the very first habitats I built, because this cougar habitat is actually, I think, the third one that I built. And I do have to say, again, thank you so much to Frontier for giving me early access. I did have this pack for about a week before launch, so that's why I say this is about the third habitat that I built after getting my hands on this pack. And what we're building here today, again, is another one-off habitat build, and the reference picture that I'm using, I think, is actually a bear habitat, but considering it kind of looks like it would hold big cats and cougars and things like that, I think it works just fine, and I'm very happy with how it came out. This one is a very simple habitat, but very fitting to the aesthetic of the cougars, right? Fitting to the North America kind of feel. I made sure to really try to use a lot of the temperate slash taiga North American trees and make it feel like it would actually fit in with the area the cougars would be in. Before we get any further, if you guys are enjoying this, I do have to ask, leaving a like and subscribing to the channel helps out a whole ton. We are actually on our way to the big 10,000 subscribers, and at that time I have some special things planned, including a Q&A video as well as a face reveal on our live streams. So if you want to help us get to that huge milestone, I would be forever grateful. And all you got to do is hit that subscribe button down below. But back to the build, what you could see me playing with there is actually something that I don't see a whole lot of people talking about. In fact, I had to laugh at Beyond Drew TV in his stream today for getting so excited. I think it was the very first thing he showed off in his stream were those little sticks. If you go to nature and you search for just birch tree or just search birch, it comes up and we got these teeny tiny little sticks. And I was gonna try to make a fence out of them, and I think they would still be great as fence pieces, but they didn't really fit the aesthetic I was going for with this particular fence. But it's really, really nice to see real small pieces coming to the game. I think that that is an awesome addition, and wonderful creators, much better builders than myself, can do such wonderful things with teeny tiny pieces like that. I think the only thing that would have made them better is if they were recolorable, but teeny tiny pieces are great nonetheless. So really excited about those, and those came in the free 1.7 update, I believe. So you don't even have to pick up the North America pack in order to get those. So go check those out. The other things that we got in the North America pack, it was an animal pack, but we did get a few signs and one statue for the animals. I am a little bummed that we didn't see a statue for every animal. I feel like that's something that should kind of just be included for every animal, because having statues outside their enclosures is such a common thing to do when you're building, that I think that it would be a really good addition to the game. But the art style and the signs that we did get are so incredibly well done. I can't even really be mad. I love how they look. And saying that, I actually didn't even use any in this habitat, but I think that they are really, really well done. Recently, I've been really loving using these beams that we got from the Australia pack, along with the mesh that we got in the last free update. Just kind of really enjoying thinking about things from a realism perspective. You know, I say it over and over again on the channel here, we use realism pretty loosely, because I don't claim to have any of my habitats be exact replicas of in real life zoos, but considering realism to the best of our abilities. So using those beams and the mesh pieces really helps achieve that look. At least I feel like it helps achieve it when I'm looking at the habitat. That's what I feel like it looks like. So hopefully you guys agree. But using the chain link here, because I did kind of want it to feel like maybe a little bit of an older habitat, not quite so brand new. I mean, it it's not an old habitat by any means, because it's still pretty natural. It's got a complete rock background, so I do take these rocks and use them to make the entire backdrop of the habitat, but just using those chain link fence pieces as the separator between the guests and the animals. And using a couple different types of fences. Now, I will say both this fence with the rope and the climbable pieces that I'm using for the other type of fence, for some reason, the cougars, even with escape off, they just morph right through the glass and just start walking across the fence that I put in front of it. So that is a little bit of a downside to this habitat. This habitat's not up on the workshop, but I don't think it would be entirely too difficult to put it up on the workshop, considering that the entire barrier is made from in-game pieces and not actual barrier pieces. So it might not be too hard for me to get up there. So I might actually look at that in the next day or so and see if I can't get that up there for you. But keep in mind that if you do use this, you might want to pull the fences a little bit further away from the glass, or just kind of be okay with the fact that sometimes they morph through, they walk along the fences, and then they get boxed up and sent right back to their habitat. I mean, it's kind of just like a really, really close up encounter with the animals. The guests, because they're not considered escaped, since I'm in sandbox and have escaped mode off, they don't freak out. They just kind of sit there and they stare at them when the cougars are like right in front of their face, not with a barrier or anything like that. So yeah, it's, you can just say it's part of the habitat. It's part of the experience. The guests love getting that close up to near death, I guess, because they're like right next to the cougars. But yeah, I'm not quite sure why they morph through the build pieces quite so much. It's kind of a bummer, but you know, I'm building this in sandbox and really just building it for you guys and to have fun, so it really doesn't bother me too much how the cougars behave and interact with it. I will say I was pretty excited about the cougars' animations in that climbing up the trees, and I put a tall tree in the very center. They climb like all the way up to the top and hang out up top there. I know that the snow leopards, I think, do the same thing, but it was really cool to see them climbing all the way up to the top of the tree. I will say my favorite thing about the cougars is the babies. They are so incredibly cute. There's something about baby animals when they have patterns or different patterns than their parents. Like, baby cougars would be cute if they were just like miniatures of their parents, right? But the fact that the baby cougars have these bright blue eyes and these spots just make them so, so much cuter. I absolutely love it. So when I first put these cougars in, I actually left my computer running and I walked away to make sure that they would have a baby. And then I came back and I probably watched the baby run around for like 30 minutes because it's so incredibly cute. It's just like a little fuzzy kitten. I think that's why I like big cats so much, is that they remind me their mannerisms of like house cats, but they're just these big, you know, ferocious wild cats. And I think it's really cool. I will say, like, the baby cougar and the American alligator, the American alligator's baby is kind of the same thing. It's got those stripes on it. I just find something about the baby animals, like I said, when they look different from their parents, when they have these little patterns on them, I think that they just look extra adorable. So I was really excited to see that in the game. And let me go ahead and actually pull up. I totally forgot. I wanted to talk about our cougar friends, as we always do, but I actually forgot to bring up the information. So let me go ahead and do that real quick, and we can talk about them. As I said in my last video, pretty excited to see animals from North America, being that that is where I live. So pretty excited to see animals like cougars. I have seen a couple in real life. I've also seen them in the San Diego Zoo. And I, like I said, I love seeing the animals that are kind of close to home. So let me see here. Okay, so pulling up the National Geographic's website, we are going to take a look at the cougars. They are listed as least concern. It says this powerful predator roams the Americas, where it's also known as a panther, a puma, or a mountain lion. So I think this is one of the animals that has like the most common names, because it's known as a whole bunch of different things. But this big cat of many names is also found in many habitats, from Florida swamps to Canadian forests. Talking about hunting, cougars like to prey on deer, though they also eat smaller animals such as coyotes, porcupines, sorry, I don't know why I said that so weird, and raccoons. They usually hunt at night or during the glooming hours of dawn and dusk, and this is actually known as crepuscular. So if you've heard animals that are awake at night as being nocturnal, or during the day as diurnal, crepuscular is awake during the kind of early morning, evening, or late afternoon, evening kind of hours. Really common for predators because a lot of prey animals are crepuscular, and so that's when they're not going to be out in the major heat of the day, and they're going to be kind of foraging for food and things like that. So a lot of predators have adapted to be active during those times as well. These cats can employ a blend of stealth and power, stalking their prey until an opportunity arrives to pounce, then going for the back of the neck for a fatal bite. They will hide large carcasses and feed on them for several days. Cougars once roamed nearly all of the United States. They were prized by hunters and despised by farmers and ranchers who suffered livestock losses at their hands. Subsequently, by the dawn of the 20th century, cougars were eliminated from nearly all of their range in the Midwest and Eastern U.S., though they then emerged in Florida, and the Florida panther now survives in that region. Today, white-tailed deer populations have rebounded over much of the cougar's former range, and a few animals have appeared in more eastern states such as Missouri and Arkansas. Some biologists believe that these big cats could eventually recolonize much of their Midwest and Eastern range if humans would only allow them to do so. In most western United States and Canadian provinces, populations are considered sustainable enough to allow managed sport hunting. I don't really like the sound of that, but it's good that they are rebounding back, which is awesome. Behavior. Cougars require a lot of room. Only a few cats can survive in a 30 square mile range. They are solitary and shy animals, seldom seen by humans. While they do occasionally attack people, usually children or solitary adults, statistics show that on average, there are only 4 attacks and 1 human fatality each year all around in the United States and Canada. So just a little bit of information about our cougar friends. I think they're such pretty cats, such pretty, pretty cats. I've seen a couple on, actually when I was in college on campus, we were kind of back up against this like rocky bluff area. And we would oftentimes, well, I shouldn't say often, every once in a while we would see a cougar kind of up on that rocky and like the chaparral type area walking around. And that was actually our mascot was the cougars because of that, I believe. So that's one of the reasons why I was excited to have these guys in the game. But getting back to our build, you can see here that I have taken that one fence and kind of surrounded everything. Because this is a one-off habitat, the thing that I have the hardest time with is making it look like it can be integrated into a zoo project. Like it's not just this cool habitat and then nothing around it, nothing in a backdrop. So I took that fence and I just kind of surrounded the whole thing with it. And then here, I'm actually making some implied educational signs. I know that we have the billboards, and in a new project that you'll be seeing debut on the channel here in the next couple days, I do use the billboards to add a whole nother level of realism to everything, because you can actually make like zoo signs and type out real information and all that kind of stuff. And although I think that that is awesome, I absolutely love that we have billboards in the game. I wish we would have had them to start, because they are super versatile and super helpful when building. There's just a certain level of charm, I guess, to making these signs out of art shapes and pieces and stuff like that. And I just liked how they looked. I just felt like kind of going back and building some of these signs because I used to build those all the time for my zoos. And like I said, I just think it adds like another little level of charm to the habitat. So that's what I decided to do. Very quick, very easy. And I just duplicated it 3 times over around the habitat. And then I took the smallest TV there is and just put the actual cougar information on it. And pretty simple and straightforward. I really honestly was not focused a whole lot on the guest areas in any of these builds that you're gonna see, because I really was just focused on the actual habitat themselves. With them being one-off habitats, I kind of don't do a whole lot on the guest area because I kind of don't know what direction it's gonna go off of to other habitats, what's gonna be nearby, is there gonna be a restaurant or something like that. I really am just focusing on the animal habitat itself. But doing just a lot of foliage, a lot of decorating. Of course, my habitats have to have nice backgrounds. They have to be pretty when you're looking at them, right? So I can't go very long without adding trees, of course. So this one has quite a lot. And using those ponytail palms, which have very quickly become pretty much my favorite tree in the whole game, because you sink them down and they look like little ferns. Or not ferns, but just like little plants. And I'm really a huge fan of using them for that. I think that it actually fit the reference picture that I was looking at, had those type of plants down around the habitat on the outside, and it worked perfectly. Here you can see just making like the most simple of simple backstage buildings that you could ever imagine. It's literally a cube with a roof. It's a square with a roof, basically. It is the most simple backstage building that you could ever imagine, because I couldn't be bothered. I could not be bothered with a backstage area for this one. I really just wanted to focus on the habitat itself. By this time, because this was like the third or fourth habitat, like I said, that I built, when I got my hands on it, I built for like 6 or 7 hours straight over the weekend on Saturday, and then I built some more on Sunday. And this one I was finishing up on Sunday, the day before the release, and I really was starting to feel a little bit fatigued from sitting in my chair and staring at my computer for so long and all that fun stuff. So I really couldn't have been bothered with the backstage area, but I still wanted to make it look like the keepers could get in somewhere. I just didn't want to leave it completely surrounded by rocks and it's like, you know, the keepers have to like rock climb into the enclosure. I wanted to make sure there was actually a door that made it look like they could get in. And then just adding a little bit of water over here on the side. I wanted to make sure that the cougars, one, had somewhere to drink, but two, I wanted to give them an area where they could get in the water and kind of splash around. I didn't give them enough room to actually swim in the water, but just enough room to kind of go over, get a drink, splash around, cool off if they wanted to, that kind of thing. At least here where I am, there's not a whole lot of like large bodies of water. There's like rivers and creeks and things like that out in the desert and the chaparral and stuff where the cougars live around me. So that's kind of what I was going for, is that they're not going to have these like big bodies of water to like swim in, but just a little bit of a creek. But then just making the bottom plaster, putting in those decals of the drains to make it look just a little bit more realistic, as if the water actually has somewhere to go when the keepers go to clean it. And then here I am putting all of the rocks into a group like I should have done in the very beginning. And if I would do this regularly, I would not have to go back through and select all the rocks. I should learn, because I do this with almost every single one of my builds. I just decided to leave it in this time so you guys could see what I was doing, but recoloring them, because I decided that the natural color that the aquatic rocks come in was not really what I wanted the overall look to be. So just making them a little bit more gray, and then taking like every other rock or every few rocks and kind of changing them to a slightly different tone, and making it look like some of them are weathered and some of them are not, you know, all the exact same color. But from here on out, it's just finishing up the floor, and then we're going to jump into some cinematics here in a couple minutes. I do include some cinematics of that adorable baby cougar, so do be sure to catch those. Again, as always, if you guys did enjoy, I really appreciate all the love and the support. If you did enjoy the video and you've made it this far, go ahead and leave a like, hit the subscribe button down below, if I could say that clearly, and I will talk at you guys in the next video. Bye!